It's hard for me to believe and accept how my life is now because of my weight. Everything's become such a struggle for me that I hardly even get up from the couch.
But I refuse not to bathe. If I ever get to that point where I'm not gonna bathe, then that's me saying I give up. And I don't want to let things get to that point. But it's still extremely hard for me to do. And I have to have help. Me and my wife Yasmin live with my mother. But I refuse to ask my mom to help me in the bathroom.
So as embarrassing as it is,
my wife helps me with my showers once I get in. I just can't reach all the places I need anymore. It's very humiliating.
Travis needs my help to stay clean. It's a lot on me, and it bothers him because it makes him feel like he's not being a man. Every now and then, he'll be like, I'm sorry, babe, you gotta do this. I'm sorry, babe, you gotta do that. But I took the vows. I gotta take care of him.
If it wasn't for my wife, I don't know how I'd survive. But this isn't the life that I promised her at all. And it tears my heart apart to have to admit that. But at my size, my body can't handle doing much of anything now. After taking a shower, I'm breathing heavily. You know, I'm trying to catch my breath. My heart is a little high rate. I'm scared that my heart, that's the first thing that's gonna go. I never know when it's gonna give out on me. So when it gets like that, I have to take a moment to regain my strength before I walk back to the couch or wherever I can sit and rest again. When I was 22, I got really motivated to try and get my life together because I met someone and we started dating. I met her at church and asked her out. And over the next year, we fell in love. And a year later, I proposed to her. And she said yes. So I wanted to get my life together for her because I was going to be married. So I got a job playing keyboards at church. I had always been interested in music, so I was glad to be doing that and making some money. And with some consistent income, I was able to get us an apartment so we can live together. But a few months after we got engaged, my fiance came to me and told me she was breaking up with me. She couldn't marry me. She wouldn't do it, so. I fell into a depression after that, you know what I mean? I was hurt. I was really hurt about that. And what I did was to eat. So I started putting on a lot of weight again. I was 25 years old and almost 500 pounds now, and I had no one.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
How y'all doing?
I'm doing all right.
All right, I'm Dr. Nazardin.
My name's Travis.
Good to meet you, and you are?
Yes, man.
Nice to meet you both. Okay, Travis, you're coming from Dallas, huh?
Yes, sir.
And you got here because you want to lose some weight?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I need to lose the weight.
Right now, this extra weight is affecting every organ and every system in your body. And pretty soon, you won't be able to move, and you're going to get bedridden. And then after that, everything is going to escalate rapidly, and your body's going to give out soon, and you're not going to survive. Okay. Yeah. So this is a very dangerous situation, and you need to make the changes now.
Right.
Because even right now, you having so much difficulty with shortness of breath, and listen to your heart is racing like 120 beats per minute. So if you continue like this, you're not gonna have very long to live.
I understand.
You understand that,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
So this is all new, Travis, right?
Yeah.
So you're gonna have to be the driving force to make the changes, okay?
Yes, sir.
And Yasmin, you need to work on changing your dynamic with Travis to where you're willing to have the argument if what he's doing is hurting himself, okay?
Okay.
Wanting to avoid conflict is okay, but to help him kill himself is not.
Yeah.
So that's where you have to draw the line if you care about him and if you want him to do this.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So let him get mad. He will get over it.
Yeah.
The day of my weight loss surgery is finally here, and I'm very excited. Dr. Now said my tests look good and that he's happy with my progress from this past month. So I'm moving ahead, and I'm feeling really good. I know I probably should be nervous, but I can't help feeling excitement today because it's like I'm about to have a rebirth to start a new life. And I'm looking forward to that. So I'm just happy right now, you know? I'm gonna get a chance to undo my past and turn it around so I can get back to the way things should be. And I'm so thankful for that. And I'm just excited to do this and finally begin the life that I have waiting for me.
Today, we are attempting to perform a gastric sleeve on Travis. He's stayed on track with another 28-pound weight loss this past month. That's not as much as the previous 2 months, but he's continuing to do well and work hard. So we are moving ahead with his surgery today. Okay, let's begin. Starting the first incision. For the next month, Travis will need to stay on a liquid-only diet until he fully recovers. And at that time, he should be able to lose another 30 pounds. And then after that, he should be able to lose at least 20 pounds a month until he gets close to the 200s. So if Travis stays on track, he should be able to get to his goal weight perhaps in about 6 to 9 months. If he keeps working hard like he needs. But he still has a lot of weight to lose. And even with this surgery, it's not going to be easy for him to do that because he needs to face all the issues behind what's driven him to eat like he has most of his life. So even though we gave him an important tool that will help him out today, Travis still has a long road ahead. And how he does from here will all depend on whether he addresses what he needs to stay on track. Because if he doesn't, it won't take long for him to stretch his stomach back out by overeating to where he can start gaining again. And at that point, he will end up back where he started, over 600 pounds and facing an early death.
It's been a little over a month since my weight loss surgery. At my last appointment a week ago, Dr. Now approved me to go back on solid foods again. So it's been nice to have something other than liquids again. Dr. Now says he's happy with my weight loss for the past month. And just to keep working hard. So that's what I'm trying to do. And I'm working to stay focused and do what I need. Our new apartment complex has a gym here. So I'm going there and working out at least 3 times a week. My next big goal to hit is to get under 350. Because Dr. Now said when I get to that point, I'm probably gonna have a good amount of extra skin hanging on me. And that I'll need to get 20 or 30 pounds of it removed by then. Which sounds like a lot to me, but I can already see some areas where that's happening. And the skin is starting to hang a little. So if that gets worse, then I'm definitely gonna need to get that removed. So that's gonna be the next big step for me that I'm working hard towards now. Dr. Now said I can be there in the next 4 or 5 months if I apply myself. And I know I can do that as long as I'm doing what I need. I've worked very hard over this past year to make the progress I have, but I still have over 200 pounds left to lose. So I know my journey's far from over. Dr. Now says if I stay on track, I'll be where I need to have my first skin removal. Even though it might be far in the distance, I can at least finally see the finish line. And thinking on how my life is going to be once I get to my goal is a big motivation for me. So I'm just keeping that in front of me until I turn my dream into a reality. And I can't wait for that.